Hey, welcome in. Well, if there was ever a cautionary tale of what wokeness can do to a man, well, look no further than Jimmy Kimmel. Here's the headline. Kimmel mocks Nelk Boys after Trump interview. Small group of YouTubers. Nelk Boys, fire back. Pack it in and let the big dogs take over, pal. Now, I had never heard of these guys, the Nelk Boys, before I watched that interview. But after watching some of the interview, it was immediately apparent that they're much better than Jimmy Kimmel. And this was obvious because after several minutes, I didn't want to throw myself off a cliff. Now, I don't know how many people have actually thrown themselves off cliffs after watching Jimmy Kimmel, but there's no way it's zero. You know, the sad thing about this is that Jimmy Kimmel actually used to be kind of funny. He was never brilliant, but he was funny. I watched The Man Show back in the day. He was irreverent. He was fun. And I guess that's the thing, maybe. A bit too irreverent, say. Yeah, and there was stuff like this where he did his impersonation of Karl Malone. It looks like he really got out the self-tanner for this one. But you have to remember, this was also before everybody went insane. So I imagine there's probably a little bit of overcompensation happening these days with Jimmy Kimmel. And I imagine he also likes getting very well paid to do a terrible show and tell terrible jokes. And if he wants to do that show and get those big paychecks, well, then he doesn't really have much choice in the matter, does he? And I guess, you know, the question of whether or not he's actually woke or he's just faking it for a paycheck is up for debate, I suppose. But it has been said that you should be careful what you pretend to be, because you might become it. Anyway, what's going on here? After former President Trump was interviewed by the Nelk Boys, a Canadian comedy group, ABC late night host Jimmy Kimmel mocked Trump and the group, calling Trump Mar-a-Lardo and referring to the Nelk Boys, who have over 7 million subscribers on YouTube, as a small group of YouTubers. I feel like there's a little bit of a denial of reality going on there. Now, this interview was actually taken down by YouTube after it had garnered over 5 million views in under 24 hours, because the video violated YouTube's terms of service. And that's because Trump repeated what he's said many, many times, that he thinks there was something fishy going on in 2020. And that's his opinion, and personally, I think he should be able to say it. But YouTube doesn't agree. And I have a feeling that if the next election doesn't go the way that YouTube would like it to, those kinds of claims won't violate their terms of service. And that's because the terms of service are bullshit and they don't mean anything. But anyway, Jimmy Kimmel is mocking these Nelk Boys. Let's take a look at their YouTube channel. 7.28 million subscribers, that's a lot. And let's take a look at some of their views. 4.1 million views, 1.9 million views, 4.4 million views, 5.6 million views, 4.5 million views, 5.4 million views, 4.6 million, 6.7, 5.3. That's a lot of views. Let's take a look at Jimmy Kimmel Live. He's got 18.4 million subscribers. So that's a lot. That's more. So I'm sure that he must get many more views on his videos. Whoa, wait a second. What's this? 15,000? 21,000? 23,000? Hold on. Let's see. The first few of the Nelk Boys are 4.1 million, 1.9 million, 4.4 million. What? But Jimmy Kimmel's got 18.4 million subscribers, but he's getting a fraction of the views, a tiny fraction of the views. I mean, 15,000 on the latest one? I mean, if we go back a little further, there's one with a million. Okay. 90,000. Okay. 123,000. That's a little better. 162,000. 89,000, 156,000. Okay, those ones are doing a little better. Let's check out the Nelk Boys again. 4.1 million, 1.9, let's go down a little bit. 6.2 million, 8.4 million, 4.5 million, 5.7 million, 6.3 million. So it looks like they're getting a lot more engagement, like a lot more engagement. So that's kind of interesting, right? These guys are getting, you know, 4 or 5 million, and Jimmy Kimmel's getting, you know, in the thousands. So anyway, but for some reason, Kimmel feels empowered to call them a small group of YouTubers. Interesting. Let's see, that prompted them to fire back on Instagram. This small group of YouTubers has way more viewers than you, buddy. Kimmel used to be way funnier, but now is just washed up and irrelevant. The only reason you even get any views is because Disney owns your show, so YouTube forces it onto everyone's home pages. Late night is where comedians go to die. Pack it in and let the big dogs take over, pal. And you know what the thing is? He's right. YouTube relentlessly promotes people like Jimmy Kimmel because they're establishment. They put forward the establishment view. There's nothing that Jimmy Kimmel is going to say that's going to offend anybody on CNN or MSNBC or in the New York Times or the Washington Post. No, no, he's going to toe the line. He's going to say exactly what he's expected to say, and he's not going to surprise anybody. So YouTube will try and force his garbage on everybody. Yes, this bland, predictable pablum is what YouTube wants you seeing. They want your clapter. They want you nodding along mindlessly. I mean, you can laugh if you want, but, you know, it doesn't sound genuine. Anyway, what was Kimmel saying? He said, Mar-a-Lardo. Oh, that's hilarious. I bet you it only took 20 writers to come up with that joke. I mean, here's the thing about shows like Jimmy Kimmel's. It has a multi-million dollar budget. It has a room of writers. You know, Kimmel's not just saying this off the top of his head. It takes a village to come up with jokes like that, like Mar-a-Lardo. But anyway, it's been making the rounds. He was on a podcast hosted by, this is really something, a small group of YouTubers known as the Nelk Boys. These guys, they show up at Mar-a-Lago in sweatshirts and shorts and logos all over their clothes. Trump sits down for an hour with them during a war. He's not the president anymore. He's allowed to do interviews with people. He's allowed to do whatever the hell he wants. Do you think Biden's calling him up asking for help? I mean, he'd be smart if he did it, but it's Biden. But anyway, he's saying to answer the dopiest questions. You know, somebody should sit Kimmel down and force him to watch his own show. One of the great things about Trump is that it doesn't matter who's interviewing him. It could be George Stephanopoulos or three doofuses who brought a 12-pack of hard seltzer along with them. He's going to answer the same way. Why is he even talking about Trump? Hasn't he noticed that the world is falling apart? Oh, actually, that's probably why he's still talking about Trump. Best to talk about Biden as little as possible these days, I'm guessing. Maybe he feels threatened by alternative media, and he actually should. Because just because you've got an establishment-approved late-night talk show, an establishment-approved YouTube channel, it doesn't mean that anybody actually cares what you think. And the fact that your establishment juggernaut is getting soundly thrashed by a YouTube channel who don't have a giant machine behind them, well, that should make you nervous. Anyway, that's all I got to say about that. Please subscribe, like, and share. It really helps me out. If you just like to listen, there's the podcast Radio Baloney. It's on pretty much every platform. If you look for it, you will find it. Thank you very much. I'll see you next time.